ain't never just tripped and pitched it. Just looked at the whole situation, cause once you look at it, you know, really do. They don't give a fuck about us.
Once again, we want to thank you guys for showing up. We're out here in the west end of Atlanta. This is the Porch Discussions and the Truth. And today's topic, we're talking about the purge of the black family. African Americans being systematically removed or killed by the police force or the nation that's here to protect us. So today, Joe is not with us, my co-star, but we got a guest speaker in who's taking Joe's place today, which is Mr. Julian Brown. Mr. Julian Brown, say hello to everybody.
Hello, everybody. My name is Julian Brown. I'm here with Drew. So I'm definitely excited to tell you guys about what's been going on, you know, worldwide, not only in the U.S., but you know, all four corners of the world. So, you know, I'm here to speak about what's really been going on as far as killing our black men and our sisters. You know, this gotta stop. You know, so Drew.
Hey, Julian, man, look, things are bad, real bad. I can't say never, because social media is really bringing things out that's been going on with us. But I never thought that in 2016 I'd have to raise a son in this bullshit, this madness that we're currently going through, man. What's your thought on that?
My thing is, you know, I mean, like, you, I have a six-year-old son, man, and you know, and to see him being raised in this this racist country that we call America, is I don't like it. You know, it's something that has to be done for us to come together, speak about what's really been going on, right, and find a solution, you know?
Right. And once again, I want to say we are live on the porch in West End, Atlanta, Georgia, and it's hot. We sweat and we got our towels, but we really out here to address some issues and talk to you guys, get some input from you guys. You can like us on Facebook. I'm Drew Takn Garrett on Facebook. You can hit me up at me. I'm RampageX45 and Twitter. Tweet me. But look, we got to talk about this issue. We got to find ways to solve it. I do want to put out there that my sincerest condolences goes out to the men and women of our police force that have been recently murdered in Baton Rouge, also in Dallas.
Right.
By no means is this discussion about violence or condoning violence. And when we get into that, I do want to bring up something that I found that Martin Luther King said, and I really want to repeat this, okay? Give me one second. All right, so I found this statement that Martin Luther King said about violence. And it says, returning violence for violence only multiplies violence, adding a deeper darkness to a night already devoid of stars. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only love can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. Martin Luther King.
That's excellent, man. No, I mean, he's right. You know, I will say, you know, when all this stuff first started happening the first part of July, you know, of course, our natural reaction is to, what's up? You know what I mean? I mean, if the white police are killing our brothers and sisters, you know, it's time to strap up. That was my initial thought. You know, because I was tired. I'm tired of all this stuff going on where it's nothing but killing on the black man, right against the black, you know, black is black. Blue against black. So my initial reaction was, I'm tired, let me find my gun and strap up. But, you know, you're right. You know, MLK was a peace giver. You know, and you know, it's hard to lash out with violence. You know, ultimately, you're going to get the same violence coming back to you. So we have to come together, you know what I mean, and find a peaceful solution. You know, and I think, you know, he was right. You know, a knife only gets sharp if you take someone's life. You know, so let's talk about something and let's find a solution.
I definitely agree with you, and I understand that frustration because I was mad as hell too. You know what I'm saying? Because it seems like it keeps happening over and over and over,
right,
and nobody is held accountable.
Right.
Nobody's being convicted.
Right.
Right here, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 names of people who have been murdered by either the police force or somebody acting as a police, and there's been no convictions. I'm gonna read these names. Trayvon Martin, no conviction. Sandra Bland, no conviction. Katherine Johnson, no conviction. Sean Bell, no conviction. Eric Garner, Raquel Boyd, Amandu Diallo, Mike Brown, Kamani Gray, Kenneth Chamberlain, Tavarius McGill, Tamir Rice, Anaya Stanley Jones, Freddie Gray, all no convictions for any of these. So basically, you're telling the police force, you're telling any other nationality, it's okay to kill black people. You won't get convicted for it. You might get a slap on the wrist, might have to spend some money defending yourself, but it's okay to kill black people. You're not gonna be convicted for it.
And that's why all these police officers are killing us black folks and getting away with it, because they already know, okay, look, I can kill Tyrone, you know what I mean? I might get suspended with pay, you know what I mean? And then within 4 or 5 weeks later, they might find me not guilty. And I mean, and I'll quit that police force, go across the street to another police force, right, and do the same thing over and over and over again. Right. You know what I mean? So, that's sad, man. 14 right. names?
Yep, that's sad, just 14, man. And it's more.
That's sad.
It's been over 532 murders this year by law enforcement of black people. 532 versus 29 cops that were killed. And you, I heard CNN say it's a war on cops. No, it's a war on black people. They're killing us.
Exactly.
532 does not equal 29.
And they've been doing this since the day of time, but now with all social media, camera phones out, you know, now it's getting more dramatized now, but this has been going on since the day of time, man.
Been going on for years, and I'm gonna tell you why it's been going on. I'm gonna tell you how I know. I remember I was watching a episode of Sanford and Son, 1977. That was the air day, and it was the episode where Lamont wanted Fred to go to the hospital because he thought he had high blood pressure, right? And Lamont was telling Fred, he was like, did you know that hypertension is the number one killer of black men? And Fred Sanford said, no, I thought it was the police.
That was 77.
That was in 1977.
Wow.
This shit is nothing new.
Wow, man. Wow.
This shit is nothing new.
Wow.
But now we have, like you said, camera phones. But now we have, like you said, camera phones,
right,
video,
right,
social media.
Right.
We're able to get it out there. Mm-hmm. But that don't mean nothing, because you can kill somebody on video and not go to jail.
Right.
Only if you're white.
Right.
If that had been a black man killing a white person, mm-hmm, on video,
right,
he'd be getting an electric chair right about
right
now.
Right. You know, we got to come together. We got to come together. No killing each other, because I mean, that's honestly, that's what the actual media wants us to do. They want us to kill each other so that way they don't have to kill us.
Right.
So we have to come together.
Make their job a lot easier.
Right, we have to come together and just be peaceful. You know what I mean? And I'll tell you one thing too. I made a commitment to myself to be nice to my fellow black person, male or female, but I have to start there. You know what I mean? And,
right,
and understand, we're all neighbors, we're all the same people, you know, so let's get together, you know, have fun, but stop all the killing, black on black, especially blue on black. You know what I mean? Fuck all these, you know, white people that try to kill us. Let's come together peacefully and get something accomplished.
Right. And right now, we're just going to take a quick break, but I got this video I want you guys to watch. Take a look at this video.
And how our culture reinforces and legitimizes that lack of democracy. Right from the very beginning, Article 4 of the U.S. Constitution defined people as property. You see, the authors of the Constitution were very interested in protecting their property, including slaves. No person held to service or labor in one state, under the laws thereof, escaping into another, shall, in consequence of any law or regulation therein, be discharged from such service or labor, but shall be delivered up on claim of the party to whom such service or labor may be due. The Indian Removal Act of 1830. Indigenous communities are forced from their homelands. Over 10 years, 100,000 native children and adults march thousands of miles west into unknown arid territory. 15,000 do not survive the journey. But over 25 million acres of land is made available for white settlers. 1854, People versus Hall. Non-whites are barred from testifying in court. No black, mulatto, or Indian shall be allowed to give evidence in favor of or against the white man. 1857, Dred Scott versus Sanford. Free blacks are taxed, but still have no rights of citizenship granted to whites.
I got one final thing I'd like to bring up before we wrap up, Julian. Mm-hmm. And I just want to ask people, how many of them heard of Larry Gordon? This is the white cop who murdered, this is the white guy who murdered two cops in Michigan a couple of weeks ago. And I never saw this on the news
either.
If this had been a black person, this would be all over the news. His face would be plastered on every station 24 hours a day. I think this was aired one time, and you never heard anything else about this guy.
I've seen this before. That's the first time I've seen this picture.
This guy murdered two police officers, and you don't hear anything about it. But yeah, the Dallas shootings you keep hearing about, the Baton Rouge shootings you keep hearing about, but you don't hear about the two white officers in Michigan that was murdered by a white man. Mm-hmm. Like I said, that's the final thing I want to do. Is there anything you want to add, Julian?
Twitter, Julian Brown on Twitter, JBZ702. You know, so I can take questions, answer them as well. But you know, we have to come together, man. We have to come together and just talk. I mean, you know, we're on the porch. It's like 95 degrees outside on a summer day in Atlanta. You know, but I'm here sweating, but I'm still here sweating and trying to get my point across to. Let's stop all this stuff, come together, and let's stop all these people trying to kill our black family. Let's come together, talk about what needs to be done, and go from there.
That's right, that's right. Again, I want to give a shout out to my daughter, Alexandria, my son, Andrew. I love you both. I'm Drew Takn Garrett. You can find me on Facebook at Drew Takn Garrett, on Twitter, RampageX45. I'm on Twitter. If you got any questions, that's a bus passing by. That sure you be live. That was a bus. You see how loud that bus was? But anyway, I just want to thank you guys for showing up with us, partaking in this discussion, and we'll see you on the next episode. Peace and love.
Cool.
Thanks, Julian.
Oh, man.
All right.
I ain't never just tripped and pitched it. Just looked at the whole situation, because once you look at it, you know, really do. They don't give a fuck about it.